You have to start with the new topic.
The properties of the angle formed by the two parallel lines and their transversal. Due to the transversal, whatever be the angles will form, what is the actual property of these angles, that you have to see now. So, what is the property of the corresponding angle? What is the property of alternate angle? What is the property of interior angles, that you have to see. When I will give the example, that time you will understand. But now you have to learn the properties. Then, which are the corresponding angle? Who will say which are the corresponding angle? All will say that angle A and angle E, angle D and angle H, angle B and angle F, angle C and angle G. But what is the relation between angle A and angle E, angle D and angle H, angle B and angle F, angle C and angle G? So, if these are the corresponding angle, so due to the transversal, this is the transversal T, this is line L and this is line M. Which transversal T intersect line L and line M in two distinct points. Due to that, whatever be the corresponding angles will form. What is the property of this corresponding angle? Then the corresponding angles are congruent. What they are said? Congruent. Congruent means equal. Congruent means same. Then the property is that each pair of the corresponding angle formed by the two parallel lines and their transversal are congruent. So you have to say that corresponding angles are congruent. In short, you have to say that corresponding angles are congruent. With the transversal, how you will show the congruency? This is the congruency sign. Equal to and horizontal, yes, this is the congruent sign. Means the corresponding angles are congruent. Then which are the corresponding angle? Angle A is 30 degrees, and at that time angle E is also 30 degrees. If this one is 80 degrees, at that time this one is also 80 degrees. So corresponding pairs are congruent, and you will show these corresponding pairs by congruency sign. So I will say that angle A is congruent to angle A is congruent to angle E. Angle A is congruent to angle E. Similarly, angle D is congruent to angle H. Then next pair, angle B is congruent to angle F. Angle B is congruent to angle F. And angle C is congruent to angle C. It's congruent to angle G. Angle G means corresponding angles are congruent. For the corresponding angle, which one is the property? When transversal will intersect the two parallel lines in two distinct points, at that time the corresponding angle formed by the transversal are congruent. Learn this property properly. I did this box, means you have to write this sentence in the basic book. Then which will be the property for the alternate angle? There are the two types of the alternate angle: interior alternate angle and the exterior alternate angle. Which are the interior alternate angle? Angle D and angle F. Interior means inside the line. Alternate means alternate of the transversal. Angle D and angle F. Angle C and angle E. These are the alternate angles. This is the transversal T, intersect line L and line M in two distinct points. Due to the transversal, this B, D and F, C and E are the interior alternate angle, and this A and G and B and H are the exterior alternate angle. What is the properties of the alternate angle? Then the property of the alternate angle is that the alternate angles are formed by the transversal are also congruent. So the sentence is that each pair of the alternate angle formed by two parallel lines are congruent. Means corresponding angles are also congruent, alternate angles are also congruent. Then I will write interior alternate angle. Angle D, this is the congruency sign, equal to sign and horizontal, yes. Angle D is congruent to angle F. Angle C is congruent to angle E. Then exterior alternate, angle A is congruent to angle G, and angle B is congruent to angle H. These are the alternate angles. Means corresponding angles are congruent, alternate angles are congruent. Then you have to go to the interior angles. What is the property of interior angle? Which are the interior angle? interior angles, C angle, C and angle F are the interior angle. Angle D and angle E are the interior angle. Due to the transversal T, this transversal T intersect line L and line M into distinct point. These are the points. Due to the transversal, the two pairs of the interior angles will form. And what is the property of the interior angle? Interior angles are supplementary. And what this supplementary will tell? Supplementary pair of angle means when two angles, when you will combine two angles at that time, when their sum is 180 degree, that time that angles are called as the supplementary pair of angles. When sum of the two angle is 180 degree, that time that pair of the angles are called as the supplementary angle. Then can I say this angles C and angle F are the interior angle, angle D and angle E are the interior angle, and what is the property? The sum of the interior angle is supplementary. Then I will write, therefore, first pair of angle R, angle C plus angle F is equal to 180 degree. 180 means supplementary. 180 means supplementary. This angle C and angle F are the supplementary angle. What is the definition of supplementary angle? When sum of the two angle is 180 degree, then that angles are called as the supplementary angle. And complementary means when sum of the two angle is 90 degree, that angles are called as the complementary angle. And these interior angles are supplementary. So angle C and angle F are supplementary. Angle D and angle E is equal to what you have to say? 180 degree. Angle D plus angle E is 180 degree. This is sum. Sum means addition. Means these are the properties. Again I will revise. The property is that the corresponding angles are congruent. Alternate angles are also congruent. And the interior angles are supplementary. What you have to say? Corresponding angles are congruent. Alternate angles are congruent. And interior angles are supplementary. Again, repeat. Corresponding angles are congruent. Alternate angles are congruent. And interior angles are supplementary. Once again, corresponding angles are congruent. Alternate angles are congruent. And interior angles are supplementary. I think you understand this property. You have to learn this property. With this box, you have to write this box in the basic book. And you have to complete your notebook. Thank you.